and to believe that we couldn't meet here again. But here we are. I don't understand others, but I do understand myself. I'm willing to take the risk, and I believe that despite uncertainty, the thing that you physically feel, the butterflies in your stomach, the constant missing of my absence, your heart racing as we sit up and talk heart over mind, the physical things you feel that make things more real, you'd assume cold hard facts would prevail. But you don't even trust yourself, you don't even believe what you feel is real, and you'd rather cower in fear than be the strong individual you are. Instead of believing yourself, believing in me, why let fear rule your life? Why let fear control what you know is real? And despite the fear, you wouldn't have to do it alone. You wouldn't even have to do all the heavy lifting. I have your back, right behind you with open arms, ready to catch you if you fall. As kids, I never liked the trust fall. My siblings always dropped me for jokes, but I still trusted them every time. Over and over again, I fell into their arms, fell on the ground, and got back up. But time and time again, I believed they'd be there for me. Maybe I'd stumble backwards once or twice for reassurance, but time and time again, we fell into trust. Time and time again, I knew I'd fall on my butt or be caught in their arms. You never realize what trust means, the weight of it all, until the person you love the most, the person you trust the most, the person you believed would show up, didn't. Until time and time again, they didn't catch you because they couldn't catch themselves, because they felt you would never catch them. It wasn't worth the risk to them, and they barely even tried. How do you move on from those who don't take risk, from people who don't trust themselves? Even when reality is no longer a facade, is that not what gets people to believe? When you show up, open your arms, genuine intent? But how could you believe in me if you don't even believe in yourself?